educating investors.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hey, Robert, how you doing, man?
Yes, and thank you for taking my call. I wanted to let you know that I've been a subscriber for a couple of years, just different members of your team, and I really enjoy it. But really the reason I'm calling is to express my sincerest gratitude for you providing that information yesterday on the small business grant. I'm a small business owner and primary breadwinner for my family, and if I can get that money, it's going to really mean a lot to my family. So
that's awesome.
Thank you for taking the time to do that.
No, well, listen, man, we appreciate you growling a problem with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day in the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Always do your best, but don't overdo. When you overdo, you deplete your body and you go against yourself, and it'll take you longer to accomplish your goals. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 152, NASDAQ up 81, S&P's up 16.5, all folks, all-time highs. We had the NASDAQ NDX 100 and the composite there at all-time highs on Friday. Dow joined them this morning. Gold contract up $21.70, trading $18.34 an ounce. We have silver up 55 cents, $27.57 an ounce. Light sweet crude gunning its way up to the $60 level right now. West intermediate actually hit, Brent actually hit $60 over the weekend. We're trading right now up $1.12, $57.97. That's gone the way of $60. Notes and bonds, folks, whole different animal out here this morning. Now, this is going to be pretty cool. The note. 10-year note, rejected lower price out here this morning, you're trading flat, 136.21. You'd have to get back inside the 136.36 to get in a higher range. The 30-year was down 15, now we're up 11 at 167.02, so the market is buying notes and bonds out here today. And King Dollar down 85 ticks, trading 90.958. King Dollar gave it up on price on Friday. We'll see where this baby wants to go. The euro is at 120 to 1 US dollar. The yen is at 105.22, and the British pound is at 137 to 1 US dollar. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Dave Mazda, who is the head of product and a managing director at Direction. Our man, Mr. Dave Mazda, gives us a good education every other week on these ETF structures. Dave Mazda, welcome back to TFNN.
Good to be back. Hope all is well.
Hey, let me ask you something. You know, So picture this, folks, okay? Dave does a huge amount of work, okay? Meaning the aspect of when you're putting an ETF together, and I remember, folks, let me tell you something. When I had the vice president of the American Stock Exchange, this is crazy, Dave, on the first day they did the QQQs, and that's when the American Stock Exchange was around and they owned them. And who would ever know? But I was looking at your ETFs today, and I'm talking about the one-to-ones. Would you ever think that you, like, let's say if we, we can talk about the moon, we could talk about the work from home, that you'd develop an ETF 6 months ago, and the way the market is, a one-to-one is even up 50% in 6 months.
Yeah, I think that's emblematic of the market environment we find ourselves in. Whether you're talking about work from home or the recently launched Moonshot Innovators, ticker Moon.
Yes.
Moon's actually up 90% since inception.
Wow.
In November. You know, some of the names in that fund, Plug Power, Workhorse, iRobot, you know, have had exceptional performance. Moon today just crossed over 100 million in assets with unbelievable trading volume as folks are getting into that fund, realizing if you in today's market, the 50 most innovative early stage companies, so they're all small and mid caps,
okay,
actually can propel the portfolio forward a lot more robustly maybe than some of the large caps have been.
No doubt. Yeah, so let's, I really want to talk about this because it's when I start looking at these charts, I'm saying to myself, so when you put together, let's talk about Moon, okay? So the symbol's M-O-O-N, folks, okay? When you put this together, is this Moon like we're going to the moon, or is this Moon that these are just very powerful stocks?
Well, there is Virgin Galactic in it, okay. So that stock is intending to go to the moon, but really, it's the idea goes back to the JFK was actually the first to coin moonshots when he was talking about putting a man on the moon.
Yes.
But so we have that inspiration of really finding companies that are going after a challenge which may not be easy to meet,
right.
But can transform the world. But in today's what's interesting in today's market, you know, whether it's the social media or Reddit talking about moonshots. Many of those names are the same. Investors have realized that we need to focus on transformation. We need to focus on disruption, even if there's light at the end of the tunnel with the COVID-19 pandemic, with the rollout of vaccinations. The world's changing,
right.
And it's changing with technology, not just technology companies, but what's happening in industrials, what's happening in healthcare. So Moon just gives you, that concentrated 50 stock exposure to all of these different innovations.
No, I love the analogy of JFK getting us to the moon, because I get it. That you're talking about companies that have a grand vision and they're willing to do the work behind it.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. Huge. So let's, and that symbol, folks, is M-O-O-N, and that's a one-to-one, okay? So now let's go over, work from home. I mean, but the bottom line is that we know that, things have changed in a dramatic front. There's no doubt. This is hitting all-time highs out here today. And, a year later, we can see that, there's some folks that are going to be going back to the office. But actually, my son and I were just talking about business in general. And we're realizing that, hey, man, listen, people can work from us anywhere in the world now. I mean, very easily, too.
That's the beauty of it. You guys as business owners can go find someone to work on the website,
yes.
or go find a coder who's in Seattle or who's
right.
in Vancouver. It doesn't really matter. It actually may be more productive and more efficient for your business than for them, because they want that kind of either freelance opportunity, or they could be full time just based out of their house because they don't need to be collaborating in an office depending upon the role. And what we're finding is more and more companies are realizing this. So it's not just pushing back dates to
right.
when people return to the office. It's saying, we can change our business model for the better. And what's interesting is a lot of folks were, a few weeks ago, we actually saw some outflows from the work from home ETF for the first time since it accepted earlier in 2020. But it continues to make all-time highs.
Yes.
So those folks, maybe they obviously took advantage of what had been a good trade, but it maybe have been a bit short-sighted. Because these stocks continue to have great momentum, the cloud, the cyber side, as investors again say, wait a minute, the earnings that they're posting wasn't just a two-quarter blip. They're showing really great results in this year, and their guidance is actually going up, not down, for 2021, 2022.
No, there is no doubt. And that's kind of why I brought up the 1999, because this is this moment, we're past the moment. It's changed, man. I mean, this
Correct.
Is where it's at. This is where it's at. Well, listen, Dave, the education is always great. We really appreciate it. We look forward to speaking here 2 weeks from today.
Thank you. We'll talk soon.
Thank you, man. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights Today, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks. Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 152, Nasdaq's up 83, S&P's are up 16.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rosa, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show here every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Now, very easy to get this newsletter, folks. Just come over to our website at TFNN. You'll see right under featured content, Mastering Probability. You just hit Mastering Probability. You hit subscribe. You can get Steve's newsletter for 1 month for $149. You get it for 6 months for $695, which is a savings of $199 or 22%. You can get it for 1 year for $1,195, which is a savings of $593 or 33%. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So whatever one you try, folks, if you like it, great. You keep it. You don't. Doesn't work for you for some reason. Bottom line, you get your money back. Check it out right on the front page of TFNN. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, there can only be one thing going on. This is a beautiful picture, huh?
It's amazing, isn't it? There's no doubt, man. You know, bottom line, Tom Brady, the team, the Bucks themselves, Steve, was so good. I mean, the defense, offense, I mean, it's pretty amazing,
absolutely.
Man. I mean,
yeah, no, it was, they absolutely peaked, or they played their best game.
Yes.
Maybe not peak, maybe they even have more.
Yeah.
But, just a terrific game. Defense, making stops and plays when they needed to. And the one thing that I liked the most about the game was Leonard Fournette, who really was one of the greatest players in college football. And when it came to the NFL, he just hasn't really had his breakout moment. And I thought that yesterday, as happy as it was for all of the players out there, I just felt like maybe that was his breakout moment, you know. And they've just put together a pretty cool team.
That's what you're bringing up. That's what I think makes this so great. I mean, listen, we all love Brady. And what Brady has done, folks, okay? I mean, even if you saw the last game when they won the championships, not the Super Bowl, the championships. You know, Brady got sick of talking to the news people saying, hey, man, get someone else up here. Because he knows it's the team, too. which is and it is the team. I mean, they're what the Patriots had done, they drained them, man. They just sucked all the money out of it. I mean, they had no ends there, right? I mean, and then you look at Tampa, it's like, man, I just love that they have a defense and an offense. I mean, and it's all of it, which is, I think, 10 times better, you know?
Yeah, it was great. It was great. So the in Tampa, I mean, you guys are on fire over there.
Yeah, they're going to start calling us Champa, right? That's what's going on.
I love it. Perfect. So, hey, last week when we were together, we discussed how the Dow may have made its seasonal low back on January 29th. And we reached that conclusion based upon this seasonal cycle chart. The seasonal cycle, again, typically we see some type of top in the first week or so in January, and then we see a seasonal bottom around January 30th. Here, our seasonal cycle low at this stage for the Dow is January 29th. So we still hold out the possibility that the markets run higher into May. But today's action, much like being the play-by-play commentator for the stock market analysis, there's a detour sign that's flashing. So the detour sign that I'm referring to, and this is a snapshot from about a half an hour ago, so the numbers will be slightly different, but still the same. And what I mean the same here is the markets are trading higher, and specifically the S&P 500 is trading higher, but so too, if you take a look at this, is the spot volatility index. So when those days happen, we pay attention. And the reason that we pay attention, this is a three-year chart that show other prior VIX S&P price divergences. What I'm referring to here, folks, is the top portion of this chart is the S&P. The bottom chart is the spot volatility index. And it's a line chart, so it's just based upon closes. And this is how you would really put this together. And here on the top, when you see price moving higher, but also on the bottom when the spot volatility index is making rising bottoms, that's a divergence that says, okay, you've got to be careful. So today is just day one. I don't have any day one examples on this chart out here, but it says that we should pay attention because of that divergence. And timing is everything. And so these divergences can go away. So you can't just trade it based upon the divergence, but you have to keep that divergence in the background, recognizing that it indicates that you could see a rug pull out here. So one of the best ways, Tom, that I've found to time the markets or put this all together is to identify some type of topping pattern, preferably a confirmed topping pattern on a daily chart, and then go look at the short-term charts to see if there are key levels of support that have failed. So as an example, here is the ES mini. This is a daily time frame chart.
Yes.
Daily time frame chart. So one of my tools to help us identify tops and bottoms, I refer to the Rhodes Momentum Indicator. And here we can see that that pattern is triggered. This is just automated by my system. It's triggered. And if we were to see a bearish reversal candle, whether that's today, it's not at the moment, or tomorrow or the next day, as long as this pattern is out there, that would confirm the Rhodes Momentum Indicator top. So the very next thing you need is a bearish reversal candle. Preferably as well, a close below the oscillator and change line. That's this little green line on my chart. That's currently at 38.62. But the first thing would be a bearish reversal candle. Without that, price should continue to move higher. Then let's assume here that there is a topping signal, just so folks know what to look for.
Sure.
Here's a 30-minute ES mini, and just so that they can understand, the tools that I use for identifying tops and bottoms work on all instruments, all time frames. This is the 30-minute time frame, which is typically what I'll go to look for a early change in trend signal. It's kind of logical, or I think it's logical. If we're dealing with a daily chart and we're going to see a change in trend, it's those shorter-term time frames where we should start to see key levels of support fail. The key level of support, or a key level of support that I look at, is what I refer to as the TD 9 count breakout level. You refer to it as just really breakouts out here. But this is an automated way for folks to be able to have an objective way to find support. So in support here, or the breakout area for the 30-minute time frame for the ES mini, and folks, you write this down on a pad of paper because this exists for tonight as well, is 38.88.25. All that took place today so far is a TD 9 count top that occurred this morning. That sent price right back to support, which was at 38.88.25. Now, if overnight price begins trading below that, we will have a key level of support that will have failed. We've got to go back and take a look and see what kind of signal is being generated on the daily time frame chart. We're not there right now, folks, but I want you to pay attention to the divergence. The reason why I say we're not there right now is because this is a snapshot from about 25 minutes ago, as of 2:45. And here is looking at the market breadth of the S&P 500 itself. And this is for weekly, daily, 240-minute and 60-minute time frame. All these speed dials are in the bullish setting.
Yeah.
They're all in the green area. Now, this is the daily time frame chart that shows the market breadth for the S&P 500, which had 266 instruments trading above the top of their profile. When I say top of profile, folks, I'm referring to resistance, versus 49 instruments trading below the bottom of their profile, of course, the bottom being support. So very strong on the daily basis with regard to the bullishness of the S&P 500. By the way, the 30-minute NQ, this topped this morning with a Roge momentum indicator pattern. But again, price just came back to its breakout level. That's at 13,597. So folks, write that down on your pad of paper. Watch that in the overnight session, because if price is trading below that, you could see an early change in trend signal. The daily time frame for the NDX, 54 constituents trading above the top of their box versus 10 trading below. And these are the final levels to be watching for the ES, the NQ, the Dow, and the Russell 2000. These red lines on my chart here for all those folks that are watching this.
Great update, Steve. Telling you. I know. We're up at these highs, and it's heavy breathing up here, man.
It is, but I tell you, when a change in trend is going to take place, these levels of support will fail.
I love it. Thanks so much, man. Have a great one. Look forward to the show tomorrow.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV. Live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 180. We get the NASDAQ up 85. S&Ps are up 18. And if we go over and we take a look at the comp first, what you're going to see, bottom line, is that you're up $85. And, you know, it's been basically climbing up. This is the seventh day in a row that you just basically keep climbing. And, you know, we go over to the note and bond market. This is where it's going to get really interesting, the note and bond market. So we had the 10-year. The bottom line is that it's very unusual, folks, that you are at all-time highs. And, you know, bonds basically have rejected lower price out here today. So we had the 10-year go down to 136.14 today. You're at 136.20. Now, as I said, it's 136.36 to get back inside the higher range. If we go take a look at that 30-year, what you're going to see is that there were buyers. In fact, I'll be able to do this. I believe the 30-year was just about hitting 2%. So the low was 166.03. You've come 26 ticks off of that. You're at 166.29. Now, let me bring this up. So the 10-year right now, still at 1.1. Let me see the 30-year, though. Yeah, there it is. So the 30-year start hitting, the high that I have is 1.996. And that level there was enough that you had a lot of buyers come in, folks. Okay, this is where the battle's going to be taking place right now, because that's quite a switch, you know, from downtown to uptown. Now, my take on that is that that's the first. When we were just talking about our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, he was talking about, you know, a couple numbers that if we get to those numbers, he's suspecting that you can get a pullback. My take, bottom line, these notes and bonds, those notes and bonds are basically saying, giving you a heads up that, okay, we very well may be coming into some kind of pullback, you know. And, you know, if we close up at these highs today and there's only 30 minutes left, there's no reason that you think that you won't close at these highs. Bottom line, you go to higher price. That's how this baby shakes out. The IWM, that baby has juice underneath it today. That's up $4.80. That's a big number. There's no doubt. In 5 days, that's gone from 304. I said, oh my God. Yeah. No, I'm sorry, 204. 204 to 226. You're talking about some monster numbers. Now, we got to go over to Bitcoin, even though, I mean, you know, the bottom line is that I don't trade Bitcoin. I'm not involved in Bitcoin. I don't think I ever will be involved in Bitcoin, but that doesn't mean a freaking thing when you see that Bitcoin is up $5,600. And we don't have volume on Bitcoin, but Bitcoin, if I just take the A to B equals C to D, has about a 54,000, I believe, if it doesn't A to B equals C to D. And it certainly has some big juice out here today. Now, what got this baby going out here today was Tesla. So Tesla, this gets really interesting what ended up happening out here with Tesla out there today. Tesla, the world's leading electric car maker, invested $1.5 billion in Bitcoin and signals its intent to begin accepting the cryptocurrencies as a form of payment, sending prices to a record. You know, bottom line is that what we don't know is that we don't know when this was invested. Here's the quote. He did this morning, folks, on a security filing. We expect to begin accepting Bitcoin as a form of payment for our products in the near future, subject to applicable laws and initially on a limited basis, Tesla said in a securities filing today. Now, what they also put in this filing, I'll get the second one. First, they had to bring this to the board to say, okay, what they are going to invest in. And I'll get to this because it wasn't just Bitcoin that they basically, they didn't say that they bought any gold and silver. Here, let me bring this back. But what you're going to see is that when they brought this to the board, under the new policy, they can invest. There it is right here. They may invest a portion of cash in certain alternative reserve assets, including digital assets, gold bullion, gold exchange traded funds, and other assets as specified in the future under updated policy. So, you know, we'll see where that whole thing shakes out. But there's no doubt when we talk about some action inside of Bitcoin, well, you got it in spades. And there's froth. Yeah, there's froth everywhere. We go into the gold market. What you're going to see with the gold market is this. So picture what happened last week, folks. What we had last week is that the metals market itself came down hard. It rejected lower price. The equities, however, did not get close to their lows, okay? And I'm bringing up one of the weakest ones right now that had been one of the strongest ones, and that's Royal Gold. Most of the equities, what they had done is that they retraced, but they rejected lower price pretty quickly. Now, when you see that, that's when it normally is saying that, hey, guess what? We are very close to the end of a correction inside of the metals market, and that's what I think we have. If we take a look at Royal Gold, you're going to see the juice that it has out here today. Royal Gold's up $3.90. Now, it's about time. It had to show that it did have some sign of strength, because Royal Gold, folks, had been one of the strongest gold equities for years, not days, okay? Bottom line is that it had been out there for years. And let me just, I believe what we just had. Yeah, well, they basically just come out with their numbers, and the bottom line, the market's liking the numbers. We go over to Franco-Nevada. We take a look at FNV. Good little pop-up, nothing heavy. An Eco Eagle. Now, this is one of the strongest ones out here and has been for a while. An Eco Eagle, that did a very slight retracement. Even when it was, you know, bottom line is that this has already taken out a swing point. We're up $1.63. It's going to need more volume, but bottom line, that looks to me like you are off to the races once again. And if we go to Barrick, and Barrick, Fidelity has been relentless in selling Barrick. In fact, they still are selling it. So until they lay off selling Barrick, I suspect that's going to be a little problem child. And what I'd be looking for is a huge sign of strength. What a sign of strength is, folks, is wide price spread, accelerated volume. And you're going to see, if you're watching a Bloomberg screen when I bring this up, you're going to see FMR right there. Look at that. The fifth, this is like a joke, that's on Friday, 17.727 million. And they still own 6.97 million. So they've been tearing apart that and pushing that out in a big way. And it's real possible that they... I suspect what really happened is that they owned too much. They had owned a big position in Barrick and a big position in Rangold. Barrick bought Rangold. They put them together and probably inside the portfolio now. You know, there's just too much of that one company. Dow Industrials right now up 163. You get the Nasdaq up 88. S&P's up 17. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I'll personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now up 177, Nasdaq's up 95, S&P's are up 19.5. We're going to do a timeline here. So we have the next bailout, $1.9 billion. Well, bailout, that's not the right word. A stimulus bill, okay, that's coming in. Now, watch this timeline, folks. This is going to get interesting. So you have the 12 committees that are meeting, and they're looking that they're going to do a vote on the floor February 22nd. That's 2 weeks from today. Now, the reason we're going through this, because we're looking at this market, and this market is always hungry for new money, okay? I mean, this market's on crack. There's no doubt about that. Okay, so that's February 22nd. And it's no doubt it's set up that, you know, you get the 50 members, you got the vice president vote, she breaks the tie, that thing goes in. Okay, so now let's break down what is going to be, this is the first get-go that what may be in this bill, folks. You get $130 billion for kindergarten through 12th grade reopenings. You get $40 billion for higher education, $39 billion for child care, $5 billion for extended food benefits, pandemic food benefits, $4 billion for home heating assistance, $1.4 billion for senior care services. Okay, so then we get down $10 billion for the Defense Production Act to produce masks and other COVID equipment, $25 billion for rental assistance. That's going to be run by the Treasury Department, $5 billion for homeless, $10 billion for direct assistance to homeowners for mortgage payments, $14 billion payroll assistance to airlines. Okay, now check this out. And this is why, with $1 billion for their contractors. Okay, so let's go over and take a look at the airline right now, because this is what you're going to have, folks, is you're going to have professional investors out here going through this to say, okay, how much are these public companies going to be getting? So this one here, $14 billion for payroll assistance plus an additional $1 billion for their contractors. So, you know, Americans not moving that much today. That's up 60 cents. Let's go take a look at United. United's up $2.44. Yeah, see, this is going to move. I mean, these airlines are going to stop moving. So that's going to be enough money, evidently, to have them move. Then let's keep going. Okay, so inside the transports. Okay, so that was only one part of it for the transports. Yeah, 14 billion payroll assistance for the airlines, a billion for their contractors. That totally makes sense, because if you're a contractor for an airline, all of a sudden the airlines get no business, then another small business has no business. Okay, now on top of this, there's going to be an additional 30 billion for transit, 8 billion for airports, and 1.5 billion for Amtrak. So, you know, when you just look at the beginning of that, it looks to me that the airlines, that infrastructure in the airlines, that's kind of clear that what will go in there. Then we have child tax credit, $3,600 for children that are 5 or under, $3,000 for 6 and above. The maximum child tax credit is currently $2,000, so that gets up to $3,000. And in order to do that, the single parent would have to be making less than $75,000. So we'll see where that goes. But that's what this market's waiting for once again. That's the real bottom line. Now, we'll see. That's a long time to be sitting there waiting. there's no two ways about that. The earnings that I have been kicking in, good earnings, no doubt about that. But the bottom line is that because the expansion has been so dramatic as we go up, the bottom line, these equities, when they come out with monster numbers, they haven't jumped exponentially. They haven't jumped that much at all, actually. If we go over to the banks, we take a look at JP Morgan Chase. Banks look like they're going to hit their highs once again. You know, we came down into this, 128 level. You're at 138 already with JP Morgan. If we go to Bank of America, we take a look at Bank of America. We have a Bank of America that's up at $33, and that high is game also. There's no doubt about it. Now, we go take a look at the commodities. Bottom line, this commodity deal is still on. Mosaic, you take a look at the potash market. Mosaic's going right after its highs. You're up $1.35 right now. This could be another ABC structure on the way up. It's going, 3 million. Yeah, there's decent volume as it's pushing up there. So we'll see if that's exactly where we're going to go. We take a look at Intrepid Potash. That is up 47 cents right now. That's at highs. And if we go over to the copper market has been active, has been strong, got stronger out here this morning. The copper stocks are getting stronger. If we take a look at Taseko, I believe this is an ABC up. Yeah, it's going to have the volume too. So you're up 9 cents. This is TGB. You're at 144. We hit 148. We need a close over the 148. That's what you need. But that looks like it's going to be in a confirmed ABC structure up. Southern Copper, SCCO. This is one of the strongest copper stocks there. This is the largest copper stock there is and one of the strongest ones. And this was given its hand away, folks, on Friday. On Friday, you had a huge amount of volume as you're coming into the swing point. You always like to see volume when you're coming into swings. Well, if you're going downtown, if you're shot, if a stock's going down into a swing, you don't want to see volume because that means it's break it. When you're going uptown, which we are on SCCO, Southern Copper, you want to see the expansion of volume. That's exactly what we got. And that's a very large ABC structure on the way up. When we do take a look at the copper market, it looks to me that, excuse me, folks, at the bottom line, that copper market actually wants to go to all-time highs. Right now, we are trading out at 367. Well, the all-time high is like 464. There's not much in between here and 464. I mean, it's already made quite a run, but bottom line, wants higher price. We take a look at Valley, that's the iron ore market. This is up 32 cents. You're trading $17.58. If we go over and we take a look at iron ore, let's see where we're at. Yep, it's be back in the 1,000 area. Iron ore right now, you're at 1,028. I think 1,049 was the last high. 1,149. 1,149 was the last high out here. And it's crucial to keep your eyes on these commodities, folks, because if in fact inflation started to kick in, which it's telling me, my head is that's exactly what's going on. You'll see it, and we have seen it first in the commodities. That's kind of where it starts first. People are going to be looking, in the bond market at a big deal. There's no doubt about that. Now, bonds have gone the other way, meaning that people are willing to basically take less of a yield out here today. Dow Industrials up 183, Nasdaq up 101. That composite's just running right into the close, and you get the S&P's up 21. Come right back.
In the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by
bam!
As well as
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 197, Nasdaq's up 109, S&P's are up 23, and one of the Tigers, I'm glad he did this too. So it's not potash, folks, it's potash. Potash would be a lot easier for me to remember, too, man. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Listen, the nitrogen stocks, they're running. Potash, bottom line, they're running. There's no doubt about it. Let's go take a look at the volumes out here. What I expect we're going to see once again is that you're going to get another contraction of volume. On the NYSE, you get $975 million on Friday. You're at $649 right now. It should do around the same. The composite, that has been hanging with volume. That volume wasn't shrinking. It's not shrinking today either. Look at this, man. This is big volume. Holy cow. We're already at $7.7 billion inside the composite. Now, that's saying that the composite is going to end up doing like 9 or something. That's pretty intense, man. Yeah, that's intense. It's they're buying. You know, that's buying and selling, but the bottom line, they're buying. The Qs are going to come in with a huge contraction of volume once again. Bottom line, we have only done 17 million out here today. We had a contraction on Tuesday, on Friday, Thursday, Wednesday, and Tuesday. And on Friday, we only did 22 million, folks, okay? So the bottom line is that the higher you get into this air, the less that the buyers are out there. But guess what? They're pushing it with price. SPY, same deal. Amazing, actually. Had a high, which is a contraction of volume, on Friday with 48 million, and the SPY's at 31 million, folks. So you're talking about some monster numbers, and meaning monster numbers in the contraction and the supply and demand curve. So the higher you get, the less that has been happening out here. But guess what? Maybe the market's just waiting for that $1.9 trillion. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night. Have a safe night. Please tell your friends to go to YouTube, search TFNN, and subscribe. Have a great one, folks.